Oh well, what do we have here?
This is the first video in a three-part series of molding some very tiny toy parts. First, we'll cover the basic strategy, and then we'll cover the actual stack-up to get the parts ready to be molded.
My name is Eric Strebel. Welcome to my channel about product design and making.
So this part right here, this part is not too difficult. It's got flat spots on the back. We can stack up some cardboard. And our cut line or split line will be right here along the natural edge of the part. So not too difficult on this SLA part right here. So this part's not too difficult. We have the split line that goes here. This is the natural split line from this injection molded part. We'll make a cardboard cutout. We'll drop this into the cutout and we'll fill in between the cardboard and the part. And it should be pretty straightforward. Not super easy, but not super difficult. This part here, on the other hand, is very difficult. There's a 3mm hole here and a 4mm hole here. The 3mm hole in the front is not too difficult as it goes with the part, right? The part comes apart this way. The piece going across, or the hole going across in the back of this is very difficult. It's pretty deep. I'm going to try to use some silicone. But ideally, if you mold this thing in real life, you have a slide and that slides in and out. I don't know. I don't know if that's the best way. I think silicone and then just hope for the best that it doesn't tear and it lasts the 20 parts that we have to make. But this is a very difficult, intricate part to cast. Very, very tough. Gonna be very challenging.
So the first part we're going to stack up is going to be this SLA part. This was created by my client. The other two are existing parts. One of them has an SLA piece attached to it. I use white glue for stacking the parts up and some different thicknesses of cardboard and chipboard to stack up this part. And I use the laser to cut everything. The laser has fundamentally changed my approach to making models and molds. What I'm trying to do here is stack up the cardboard so that we can get a nice flat surface to mount this part on. There's a little bit of squeeze out of the white glue right here. I'm just using an X-Acto blade to scrape that off so that I can keep a nice clean edge along the existing master part. The part was provided to me by the customer and they primed it and made the master, so I didn't do anything here. The next piece I'm gonna stack up here is gonna be a piece of acrylic. It's just what I had laying around and it worked out really good to have a nice strong surface. Again, I'll white glue everything in. There's a couple notches there to accommodate the part. Again, we're just looking to create a nice flat surface to mount everything to. I'm gonna use another piece of mat board here underneath, let's call those legs, and I'm just filling in all the little places where silicone could possibly go. Ultimately, these pieces that I'm adding will be removed when we mold the second half of the mold in silicone. For right now, we're just trying to block everything and stack everything up so we don't get silicone going in behind the part. And I just search around and use different thicknesses of cardboard and mat board and Bristol board for all my stuff to get the right thicknesses so I can keep making a flat surface. And you'll see as I'm going here, we're just building up, and you can add as many layers as you need to get the part ultimately nice and flat before molding. I use the laser, another flat surface. We're just building that all up. You'll see those two little holes in the back. Those I cut by hand. It just wasn't worth my time to do that on the laser to measure everything out. I could do that much quicker using the X-Acto blade. Here we're using a glue stick and some very thin little pieces of Bristol board. Maybe Bristol board to fit underneath the parts of the head here and kind of fill them in again so the silicone won't seep behind it. One of the really challenging things about molding these parts in particular is the scale of the parts. They are quite small. You see me using tweezers, and I really have to zoom in with my lens of my camera just to get close enough so that you guys can actually see what's going on. I use these Lure Lock squeeze bottles. I sell them on eBay, and I will leave a link to them in the description below. They are fabulous for squeezing out precision amounts of glue and putting things together like this. So this is my key. This will go around the part, and this will prevent the silicone and then ultimately the resin from going everywhere when we do the casting. So we're going to take this piece that we've stacked up. We just need a little bit of white glue here, and we're going to place it inside the key. And you can kind of see that key surrounds the part and provides kind of like a moat so that when there is resin, when we do cast in there, it can't come out the sides of the mold. And I'm going to add an additional piece here just to kind of key the part even more. You'll notice there's radiuses on all the corners, and I'm trying to make it real obvious for myself later on when I do my molding, or my casting, I should say, so I know exactly how the two halves go together, so I don't accidentally put the parts together in the wrong way. I'm just trying to make things a little bit more obvious for myself. And the ridges on the different layers of the cardboard actually help hold it together. And we're going to seal up what we've done in cardboard now using some shellac. And this is just to prevent the silicone from seeping into the cardboard and getting a nice surface. All right, on the second part, again, we're going to use the laser. We're going to make our basic stack up here, and the part's going to fit inside of here. Ultimately, this is kind of a little preview of how it's going to fit. And we're going to cut out a little bit in the front. There's actually a hole in the front of this part. I believe it's like a little cannon or something like that. And so I'm removing a little bit of the mat board here so that the silicone will have a better chance of flowing into the front. And this part here is my key. Now this one has some sharp corners on one side and rounded on the other. And this will act as my guide to put the mold together in only one way. Right before, we did it a little bit different where we had that little notch, and this is just a simpler, cleaner way of basically doing the same thing. We'll add our little stack up, and in this case, I'll add the shellac a little bit earlier than we did before so that there's no chance of getting any shellac onto the part. Add a little support piece in the back here, and then we'll be able to drop our part in. You'll see how that all kind of works, right? I'm getting the cardboard as close as I can to the part. We'll end up filling in the rest with clay, and we'll do that in the second part of the video. You'll see how that works. So we got two of the four parts done. Let's do the third stack up. There's actually two pieces here. There's a left and a right. I believe these are like arms, and this is the most difficult part of them all. I need to make some little brass parts. I do not have a lathe or anything like that. I'm using a piece of an X-Acto blade put in a cross slide vise to cut my 4mm piece of brass. So very, very simple sort of homemade machining done on my drill press. And I have a video about drill press machining, and I'll leave a link to that in the description and a link right here on the right on the top that you can watch as well. Very, very simple. I just need a tiny little piece of brass to plug up the holes on this part. And again, we're going to key this part as well, just like we did on the other ones. We're going to stack up these little D shapes, and that's going to allow us to put the mold together in the end in the right kind of way. Again, using white glue. And you may ask, well, why are you using white glue? The reason I use the white glue is that it basically is easy to dispense, dries pretty quickly, And it's not too strong, right? I use it, you'll see me a lot of times using it to hold down parts. It's water soluble, and so it can be removed. And so it's just an easy medium to use for gluing stuff together. We'll laser cut out the base, and here I am back to creating a key. Now I create this key because it has kind of a natural notch for the brass tube to stick out. And then that'll aid me in putting the piece together.
These little pieces on top right here that are added onto the toy part are going to cause problems, as well as the big hole that runs through here. That's why we're going to plug up this and this and hope for the best. The up and down is easy. Those are plugged with those pieces inside of there. Just little pieces of plastic. These have this brass, they'll get clay on the ends of them. We're going to clay them in now. These are super hard and they're very detailed.
You may ask why I used brass. Well, it's a piece of stock material that I had that was the right diameter that fit in the hole. That way I didn't have to turn anything down, so I just used the brass tube, and ultimately they'll get clayed up. And here we're adding another layer or a key on the outside, again, just to help line things up when we mold in the end for silicone and then for casting. Seal everything with shellac. In the next video, we'll cover the clay work that is bridging the gap between the part and the mat board frames that we did here in the stack up. So these are the three parts, all finished and clayed, ready to be cast. I will cover silicone molding the A side and then removing the parts and casting the B side in the next video, and then the final video will be the actual resin casting of the parts. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Rock on. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.